and will recognize on a 2-to-1 ratio members on the Democratic side. The gentleman from Illinois, Mr. LaHood, is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and Mr. Secretary, welcome. The country and our health care system is well served by your leadership. I know you testified yesterday for almost 7 hours. You did the press conference last night, and you're here today for 3 or 4 hours. So thank you. I just want to talk about rural health care, but before I do that, I listened to Mr. Doggett's comments, and he must have watched a different press conference than I watched last night, because I objectively watched that entire press conference, and I think it couldn't have been more reassuring to the country. The team of physicians, researchers, medical personnel that were put in place by this administration and under your leadership gave confidence to the country. I know he mentioned, talked a little bit about community spread. I wonder if you could just comment on that for a second.
Thank you, because I do think that exchange could unnecessarily worry the American public. When we say, when the CDC says, I say, the President says, that it is quite likely that we will see more cases and quite likely we will see community spread, that could be in one town, a locality, it could be in a neighborhood, it could also be nationwide. We say could. We have to prepare for all eventualities, and we have to educate the public about the potential for eventualities. That does not mean they will happen. It means we, responsible stewards, prepare for them. We have this 15th case in California that could be a potential first community spread in the United States. We have to now do the epidemiology behind that. We have been consistent from day one about this messaging across all levels of the government.
Thank you for that. Thank you for clarifying that. And I enjoyed hearing your comments at the beginning on your rural health care task force and putting the governor in charge of that. Appreciate that. I am concerned about rural health care. I have a district, 19 counties. I border Iowa and Missouri, and very interested in this subject. And I know as part of your four-part strategy to transform rural health care, increasing rural access to health care is a priority. In Illinois, over the last 5 years, frequent mental distress has increased by 14%, and suicide now is the third leading cause of death for people ages 15 to 35 in Illinois. Healthcare providers in my district are focused on the need for increased behavioral health and mental illness services to address these troubling statistics. And while there are many examples of innovative health approaches in my district, I just want to point out one. Unity Point Health in Peoria, Illinois, is working on solutions to help broaden access to behavioral health providers through community organization partnerships. And they recently started a nonprofit organization called Unity Place that will work to better understand the unique mental health needs of rural communities in my district and how to transform our behavioral health system to ensure better delivery for these necessary health systems and services. I wonder if you could discuss some of the successes you've seen from some of the programs and how the department plans to expand access to programs like the Behavioral Health Workforce Education and Training Program and the Zero Suicide Initiatives.
Absolutely. And as you said, we need better behavioral health and mental health care in rural America as well as all America. We've got to have a sustainable business model. They've got to work that they're economically viable. We've got to make sure that we're focused on key activities like suicidality, mental health, prevention, health promotion. And then third, we have to use telehealth. So telehealth can be an important part of behavioral health delivery in rural America in using technology and innovation. And fourth, we've got to get the next generation of providers, whether nurse practitioners or primary care or PAs, and let people practice to the maximum of their license, especially in rural America.
Well, we look forward to working with you on that. Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
Thank the gentleman. Let me recognize the gentleman.